And welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect 3, Blind. I am the RPG chick. We are going to head to... What the hell am I saying? I finished this, right? Minos Wasteland done, yes. Oh my, we're running low on fuel? The Asari! We're heading to the Asari system, sorry guys. Before I head there, let's fuel up. Now I forget the name of the system. It's, well, a cluster rather. I know it's towards the, you know, the left side of the galaxy map. And we're probably going to be fighting Banshees because they appear to be... Well, anyway. Hey guys, I'll like just go there already, but...
In the early 2160s, the Alliance began aggressive colonization.
The Reapers...
The Reaper called Harbinger is believed to be the oldest. Banshees are the corrupted Asari often found leading a Reaper strike force.
Boom. So yeah, they're having issue with, and it even says here.
The Reaper called Harbinger is believed to be the oldest and largest in the Reaper Armada.
Yeah, imagine that. We haven't read across him.
Banshees are the corrupted Asari often found leading a Reaper strike force.
The Ardat-Yakshi
create them specifically from Asari with active or latent predispositions to becoming Ardat-Yakshi, a rare neurological condition that enhances the Asari's biotic power while causing the immediate death of anyone she mates with.
Like Morinth from Mass Effect 2. So this is heads to some kind of compound for the Ardat-Yakshi. So we know what's going to be going on. Nimbus cluster. Boop. Okay, so we've got... Wow, it looks like four different systems. So I'm going to be reading planet descriptions. This might be all planet descriptions this time, guys. And looking for stuff. So this is the Pelion system. Zosteros. The dense atmosphere of nitrogen and carbon monoxide has turned Zosteros into a hothouse of enormous windstorms that blow toxic gases nonstop. Its most valuable deposits are cobalt and plonium, which netted it the number 3 spot on the list of amazingly poisonous planets on the popular vid show Your Awesome Galaxy. I think it would be better if it was Your Amazing Galaxy. The Reapers appear to have destroyed the camera drones here, as well as any scientific stations the Asari may have maintained. Yeah, too bad it didn't poison the Reapers. Stenia. The most temperate planet in the solar system, Stenia is a terrestrial world with a light atmosphere of nitrogen and argon. Asari from neighboring Trategos built mining operations around the southern pole after discovering mountains with veins of iridium and osmium. Number 3. Trategos, just mentioned. Largely frozen ice except for liquid seas at the equator, Trategos has the coldest winters of any Asari colony, taking it down near the second tier of habitability. Trategos' colonists are a hardy bunch, using the freezing winter months to test whether newcomers have what it takes to carve out a life on the planet. Yeah. Trategos' colonists are fighting the Reapers in a guerrilla war, their best resource being submarine vehicles that can slip under the sea ice to mask their heat. Wow, really? Unfortunately, these have not proven good tools for taking back population centers from the Reapers, and for now the colonists will have to be satisfied with commando actions to harass their synthetic oppressors. I like that. Synthetic oppressor. It's actually really cool sounding. Atus. You know, and I've never seen from the first or even the second game, maybe hinting at a bit, it looked like the Reapers were just coming back to destroy us, wipe us out, not turn us into slaves and use our genetic material and change everything around, and that it would take them 10 years to like completely subjugate us. I figured they'd just come back and decimate us. But I don't know, I guess they might have... What's the... retro? Like, retro historically? I can't think of that word. It's called a retro... crap, I can't remember. They retroactively change it because they can't make it so tough that we can't defeat them, right? The rock and ice planet Atus's... The rock and ice planet Atus's position was ideal for collecting data on extrasolar activity. According to star charts, the Asari had a small VI-run system of satellites in geosynchronous orbit with the planet. This system broadcast the first warning that Reapers had come through the mass relay, and mangled metal around the planets indicates that the Reapers did not appreciate their presence being advertised. Well, too bad for you, man. Alright, so... we're gonna find stuff here.
Signal confirmed.
Excellent, both together. That's a lot of fuel that we can't collect. It should stay here if you can't collect it all, you know, like... especially if you couldn't collect any of it. So there's something on this Tritagos planet. Possibly something under the ice. Ooh, I hear something. Barely, I heard something under the, you know, under everything. Probe launched. Intact Reaper weapon? Question. So this is something with the question marks. We have to go to Liara's quarters and figure out on the terminal there. 50% you mean there's more. Alright. I do want to find... where? Wow, that's a lot of friggin' fuel that we could not get. We have one more chance. So we found here one of these two, and basically we can flee that way or that way. Nope. Hehe. My god, that's a lot of frickin' fuel. Wait, 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 no.
Evasion successful.
Damn. Alright. We'll head to Agayu. This is a really pretty system. Pretty sure we found everything though. Wow, just two... this thing's hanging out in the middle of nowhere. A binary star. Carcosa. And Carcosa. Carcosa was thought to be a naturally occurring hothouse planet until an Asari expedition discovered palatial ruins on its barren surface. Likely the seat of an ancient city, the crumbling edifice dates back more than 2.7 million years. The only intact chamber appears to be a throne room overlooking a large depression believed to have once been an enormous lake. There is evidence that the people of Carcosa polluted their planet until it became uninhabitable, triggering a runaway greenhouse effect and spoiling the planet's fresh water supply. Research into the planet's long history will have to wait. Asari scientists evacuated when word of the Reaper attack reached the system, leaving behind data drones to explain their findings to anyone who survives. Really? You think the Reapers wouldn't give a crap doing all that? Nirgas. Stray planet. Nirgas is an icy planet far from the system's twin suns. Star charts indicate that Nirgas once orbited the binary star in a figure 8 pattern that proved too unstable to maintain. The planet is now hurtling out of the system. Wow, really? Where are you going? Gonna hang around the galaxy? See the galaxy? Yes, all the sights? Technically, you could do that. You're not a sentient organic life, so the Reapers won't care what you do. Just looking for anything. Oh, what? It's gotta be behind the planet. Haley? Oh, we're looking at a star. What? This is the first I've ever seen of this. Haley is an orange dwarf star, the cool companion to Agayu, a yellow-white F-class star that is the primary source of mass and light in the system. Wait. We can't scan the main star, just a smaller one. First time ever, guys. Wow. I was just passing through it looking for something like fuel. Since we found like 3 billion gallons of fuel in the last system. I thought I heard something. That's the only problem, guys. I can hear myself on the microphone. That's not... It's, you know, through the speakers. That's how I know it's working. For the most part. I'm not picking up anything. So sometimes I can't make out. I think I hear something. Possibly. But every time I think I did, I really didn't. Maybe there's nothing else here. Okay, let's scan over here. Let's go between these two and see if I can scan them both.
I found something.
Found something here. On Carcosa. I wish it kept rotating. Probe launched. Library of Asha. That might have been one of the things you were looking for. To go back to the Citadel. 100%. Okay, cool. Now before we go to Mesana, I'm going to check out Kalini. Or am I? That's why we have all... That's why we found all that fuel. Ridiculous. Oh, jeez.
Reapers eluded.
I gotta go back and get gas. They're so close to the relay. I'm trying to come in from that side. Which means I have to come in not only from that way, but facing that direction.
Evasion successful.
Thank you. Now we go back here. Otherwise, I wouldn't have been able to use that field. But if you're going to take all that fuel, put it in the other systems, not the system you land in. Because naturally, you know, if you're well prepared, like I was, you're full at that point. Oh, and I cut that off, didn't I? Alright, we'll be able to make it to both now. Almost done with everything.
Reapers eluded.
Right out of the relay. We only have one or two more assets to find. 83% already. The Kalini system. Ithrone. Hold on a second. Vast swaths of Ithrone's surface are covered in thick ash, spewed into the air by chains of volcanoes across the planet. Beneath this layer of soot, Ithrone has an iron core and significant levels of cobalt in its crust. Pania. A rock planet exploited for minerals by robo-miners, Pania was named for an ancient mythological Asari hero. Her music was so stunning, the goddess... You know, I'm going to say Athame, but I think it's a theme, they pronounce it. Granted Pania anything her heart desired. Differing legends reflect the variety of hero cults of the time. In some stories, she became the first ruler of Armali, while others claim Pania took to the stars with Athame herself. The robo-miners' orbital stations here have been destroyed. A number of life pods can be detected, but most are in the red, indicating that their oxygen ran out long ago. That's it. How dare you hurt the Asari? They learn how to write and everything. Lemnia. Referring to, what's his name? Our Prothean squad mate's, thing that he said to Liara, and she's like, excuse me? As with Pania, Lemnia had mining facilities in orbit, remotely controlling machines on the planet's surface to recover Lemnia's highly valued transuranic elements. Transuranic elements? Unfortunately, the miners made no secret of their presence, and to find all traces of them and wipe them out, all the Reapers needed to do was access the extranet. What? The Reapers access the... Why do they care? What? They're accessing the extranet? Please. That's ridiculous. Alright, let's... look for fuel. I think all the fuel's in that one system. Something here.
Signal confirmed.
Yay, fuel. A little bit. But it's all we needed, actually. They're gonna come right from here, so... Oh, we're 100%. Never mind.
Faster than light jump successful.
I'm so used to the one planet, one, you know, fuel thing. Our final destination, Mesana. I went past. Alright. So check out Lissus last. Lemetis. Lemetis is a desertified rock planet with a thin atmosphere of carbon dioxide and monoxide. The surface has water ice as well as occasional liquid water near volcanic areas. The planet has an abundant supply of zeolites, which the Asari use for water purification, and an ingredient in detergent, as well as a shielding material for disposal of radioactive waste. This stuff, zeolite crap, is really useful, isn't it? A small colony still maintains the mining equipment. Despite centuries of colonization, the Asari have developed Lamedis at a modest pace. The planet shows no sign of resource exhaustion. Colony founded in 430 BCE. Population is 12,550. Capital is Irira. Third planet. Medokos. Medokos is a medium-sized gas giant. Although its mass exceeds that of Jupiter, the planet is somewhat denser and thus smaller. A large number of moons, planetesimals, and other detritus orbits the Medokos as its gravitational pull has cleared excuse me guys, cleared the neighborhood of material that might otherwise form an asteroid belt. Still a little congested from the cold I had, you know, a couple weeks ago. It likes to stay with me. Shastessia. A hydrogen helium gas giant, Shastessia is a twin to its more massive neighbor Medokos in more than one sense. The two are named for a semi-mythological pair of twins. How could you be semi-mythological? From Asari antiquity, who ruled neighboring city-states and had a lifelong dialogue about the best form of government. As the legend goes, Shastessia died before her vision of a democratic republic could be realized. Her sister, Medokos, then took up the cause, sacrificing personal power so that all free landowners in her city would have a voice. Though historians doubt that the changes were entirely altruistic, pointing to uprisings that demanded representation, the development was a step towards modern Asari government. Okay. And last one. Somewhere around here, yes. Vilius. Or second to last planet. Vilius is a hydrogen methane ice giant drifting out in the frozen depths. Its orbit hosts rings of rock and ice as well as many moons, all drawn from what would otherwise be a secondary asteroid field similar to Sol's Kuiper Belt? Vilius is named for a trickster figure in Asari mythology, a crafty animal called a manal that seduced Asari maidens who then gave birth to hideously deformed offspring. Oh my god. In the tales, Vilius is caught and punished, but they serve as a warning to young Asari not to initiate a bond with anyone they cannot trust. Yep. Watch out on Facebook. They're all there, let me tell you. All those manals. I'm gonna look at Lesus. Not gonna land there yet. I'm gonna check out the. Hold on a second. Lesus is an unpopular garden world with characteristics just outside of the comfort zone of the Asari population. Its gravity is a little too high, its diseases a little too virulent, and the soil inhospitable for growing food. Further information is difficult to come by. The Asari government is uncharacteristically silent about Lesus. Yes, because the Ardat-Yakshi there, they don't want the world to know how very few of them can turn out, because they are dangerous. Normally, a garden world settled so long ago would be lightly populated, but little light pollution can be seen on Lesus' night side. Colony founded in 473 BCE, its population is unknown, because it's a secret. Capital is Maria. Now, I wonder if we'll run into Samara here, because she only knew of three Ardat-Yakshi. You know, I bet they're gonna. I'm trying to remember this word too. Retroactive. It's retroactively changing the canon. The history of the world. As of Mass Effect 2, I'm pretty sure she said there were only three Ardat-Yakshi still alive. One was a daughter she had to put down. I might be remembering this a little wrong. Maybe it was two. I don't even know. I believe one was a daughter she had to put down. Another one stayed in the colony and agreed to, you know, never use her Ardat-Yakshi powers and not to mate with anybody. And the last one was Morinth, who we ended up, you know... Well, she died in Mass Effect 2. Pretty sure Samara killed her. Kind of helped a little bit. Now I'm going to go back and... Like, I'm going to go back and watch that video and see what she said. We're 100%, so there's nothing in this system to find. So I'm not going to look for anything. Figured I'd check that. Let's land. Okay. Gotta bring Liara for this. That's a must. I really... And Javik is the name I was thinking before, our Prothean squad mate, of course. I don't want to bring Ashley because I have a feeling she's going to spout some more xenophobic crap. And, yeah, this isn't going to be pretty. So let's keep her out of it. Javik is... These guys both... Well, she hasn't exhibited signs of this since the first game. In the little bit we saw in the second game, I don't remember her putting down non-humans so much. Let's bring Liara and Garrus. I don't want to hear the negativity from him or her right now. I mean, maybe it'd be interesting for you guys to hear, and in that case, I apologize, but... the weapons they have are fine. I want to do Dominate first. I want to max that out. 5 points. Oh, that's 6. I have to choose proximity mine or armor piercing ammo. Okay, so we gotta choose. Now, I don't even use it as a mine. I just put it right on him. I guess it works that way. Slow target's movement speed. No, just kill him outright. Increase damage. Damage. Recharge speed. What about this? Ammo capacity, headshot, and... Again, I'm not really sure how effective that is for squad mates. Let's... do damage taken from all sources by 20% for 8 seconds. So they become, like, vulnerable to, like, everything. Which is cool. Liara has 3. I want to max out her warp ammo next, so I'm not using her points this time. Bloop.
Dig up any information on the mission, Liara?
I did, and I now understand why High Command wanted to hide it. We're headed to an Ardat-Yakshi monastery.
Ardat-Yakshi? Like Morinth?
But we knew that.
Morinth chose to be a killer. These Ardat-Yakshi isolated themselves to avoid that. But it doesn't mean they're harmless. Their urge to feed can be powerful. That's why High Command sent in commandos to investigate the monastery's distress signal.
So what does the Sari High Command want us to do?
If there was a chance the Ardat-Yakshi could break loose, the commandos were to purge the monastery.
Purge? You mean destroy?
They would have brought heavy explosives with them, yes.
Is this really necessary?
Morinth was dangerous, but are the Ardat-Yakshi this big of a threat?
Morinth was just hitting her stride. Ardat-Yakshi who kill leave behind astronomical body counts.
What?
It's why they can never be free, and why they're such a great source of shame to the Asari. That's why High Command won't rest until this place is destroyed. They'd never risk a single Ardat-Yakshi getting loose.
Define astronomical, because... how many quickies can you have? bombs are a last resort.
Don't assume anything. Maybe the Ardat-Yakshi sent out the distress call. If the Asari want us to destroy this place, I need to know what happened.
Agreed. Once we give a report to High Command, they'll stop wasting lives here.
It is a bunch of them. There's a lot of them. So why would Samara run into so few of them? All of them being her daughters. We got Codex and Journal. Asari commandos disappeared while answering a distress call sent from an Ardat-Yakshi monastery. Investigate the monastery and destroy it if necessary. I got secondary codex. Oh yeah, everything else is for council races must be under primary.
The Asari were the first.
Ardat-Yakshi, demon of the night winds, or Asari suffering from a genetic disorder preventing conventional melding of nervous systems during mating. Instead, Ardat-Yakshi electrochemically ravage their partner's nervous systems, in extreme cases leaving victims as vegetative invalids or corpses. Asari psychologists regard this incapacity for mental fusion as preventing the development of empathy, leading to psychopathy. Psychopathy? There is no known cure. The disorder generally begins in infancy, reaching full pathology during maiden adolescent sexual development. While seductive and sexually driven as other Asari, Ardat-Yakshi are congenitally sterile. Ancient Asari mythology held Ardat-Yakshi as gods of destruction, depicting them as villains of countless legends and as the anti-heroes of numerous Asari epics. Contrary to popular belief, Ardat-Yakshi are neither extremely rare. What? They changing it. They were rare. Around 1% of Asari dwell on the AY spectrum, nor are they all murderers. Well, that I knew. Most cultivate and discard countless exploitative or abusive relationships during their legally marginal lives. Despite rumor of Ardat-Yakshi syndicates, by nature, Ardat-Yakshi are incapable of long-term cooperation. As a disproportionately wealthy species, Asari employ their economic reach and media ownership to hide the AY pathology from the galactic community, placing most Ardat-Yakshi in monitored work programs or seclusion. Only the most aggressive cases are sentenced to sanitaria and prisons, or to the execution lists of Justicars. Justicars, guys. Justicars. Are we going to meet a Justicar in this mission? Examine the shuttle. Oh, there's someone there. Oh, that's...
my visor is an IR, says this shuttle's warm. Recent visitor.
Try that. I don't want to fly around so much, I still feel like I'm flying around. Assault Rifle Stability Damper. Number 2. Right.
Elevator disabled. To prevent entry or escape, I wonder.
Well, doors open very abruptly, don't they? I got more flashlights and scary music. Was that you? I was like, what's that noise? Banshee. Screaming like a banshee. You guys have watched that movie, was it Night of the Zombies? They were screaming like a banshee. These things gonna jump out and scare the crap out of me. Hit the lights, guys. Okay, no chance of that.
What was that? Stay sharp.
Spare ammo 3 for sniper rifle. 7,500 credits. To our staff and students, attached is our new daily schedule. Please note that wake-up time has been moved forward 15 minutes. Again, 15 more sleep. Floor wardens can download chore lists later this week. Please see Matriarch Galay or myself if you have any questions or concerns. Sincerely, Superintendent Jethra. Okay, we got wake-up, breakfast, morning meditation, study period, chores, midday meal, classes, study period, supper, evening meditation, free period, and curfew. You know what? This is like we're fighting the Banshee for the first time. Nobody here in our squad has any idea what's going on. Which leads me to believe that the DLC is supposed to take place after this mission at some point. I'm not sure which way we're supposed to go. Find the Asari Commandos. Which way? Wait. Oh, behind me? I didn't turn around.
Reapers. Looks like we know why the commando teams went silent.
We've been walking over these bodies.
This monastery's out of the way. What do the Reapers want with Ardat-Yakshi? Anything useful?
A floor plan marked with the nav point location of a bomb. It's in some place called the Great Hall.
At least it's no surprise Nuke gone to Chunka, but the commandos want this place gone pretty badly.
It seems drastic.
Ardat-Yakshi or not, evacuating this place would have saved a lot of lives. If there's no survivors, let's get to the Great Hall and set off that bomb.
That's in Paragon. Great Hall's that way, so let's see what's this way. A reminder! Students are not allowed to visit each other's quarters or to meet in rooms unsupervised by staff. Oh, so they do it to each other. Students are also forbidden from extranet communication without approval by senior staff members. There are no exceptions to these rules. First offenders will have their free time revoked for a month. Further violations will be met with confinement. Our monastery is our shelter. For it to remain that way, we must take or make sacrifices. If we do this, I have faith we can continue to enjoy the order and peace this place has given us. Matriarch Galay. Interesting. That doesn't open.
Great. See you there. Oh, and delete this once you listen to it. But like last time.
She didn't delete it. I wonder what Vanya is. Are you watching porn? Vanya. Oh, Vanya. Is this where he came in? No, I think we came in over there. Hate this dark, man.
I heard something. That was me. Sorry.
This is why I can't even play horror games, guys. I get scared with this crap. They are pretty scary looking, but we attacked them from a distance. In a Leviathan deal. No. Was it Leviathan? Yeah, Leviathan. Pistol melee stunner. Number 3. Anyone in here? Huh. Galay's electronic signature. Oh, I got intel for that. Alright. Another unknown thingy. Okay. Oh god, stop. At least maybe we'll have some more light this way. I can't save. So that one works. I didn't even try that door, but I figured out that that door doesn't work. You know what? That's what they do, though. They just want to make you nervous, but nothing really attacks you in the dark. They wait until you get out in the light. They're like, no, no, this isn't a horror game. Let's give them light. And then they'll be attacked. There's like nothing around here. Okie doke. Saving a lot, I know. Hello? Anybody down there? Nobody but us banshees!
Very good. I almost didn't hear you.
I knew it! I love it!
Samara?
It has Yay.
Been some time, Shepard.
You yes, it has.
You are a most welcome sight. The corruption here runs deep.
What brings a Justicar out here?
My daughters have lived here for centuries, Garrus. I've come for them.
More than one?
Unfortunately, the Reapers had already infested this place by the time I arrived.
Well, I feel stinky asking this, but if I choose one of these two, this will go away. So are your children a threat?
You met me hunting down your other Ardat-Yakshi daughter. Are these ones just as dangerous?
Falair and Rila have followed the monastery's rules ever since they arrived. They've shown no inclination toward violence.
Okay.
And you're here to save them.
They are my responsibility. And it's one that cannot be abandoned, even as our galaxy crumbles.
She is very responsible. That much we've learned from her. And more. We've blown the place up already. We'll help search.
Let's go together. Maybe your daughters can tell us why the Reapers hit this place.
I suspect they will have much to tell us. It has been centuries since I last saw them.
Damn. Centuries?
We're out of time.
Does she know what's going on?
We'll meet again. I will draw these creatures off.
Wait!
She doesn't know what the creatures are.
Let's go.
She doesn't realize she could be fighting her daughters. Well, we're supposed to go there. Great Hall. Let's see if there's anything else around here to see. There's a PDA.
My name is Tasha Bori. I'm wounded. Bad. Give this to my bondmate, Wishra. Asked her to go to the Citadel.
Aww. Does that work with two Ardat-Yakshi, though? They don't try to... I guess maybe they cancel each other out? They don't feed off each other's nervous systems like that? Because they were given orders not to go in each other's cells. I figured it was because, you know, they'd kill each other or one of them would die. But maybe not? A dead Asari commander left a message to be delivered to her bondmate, Weshra. Find Weshra on the Citadel and deliver the message. I like that, bondmate. She was my bondmate. That's pretty cool.
The fight didn't last long by the look of it.
It wouldn't. The monastery only had a few guards to protect it, not an army.
Yeah, it's quiet because we're going to be attacked by the freaking things. I'm glad I can pause like this. From what I heard, Mass Effect Andromeda, we will not have this. It's all action. And I don't like that very much. Everything else looks great, exploring and stuff. I'm just hoping there's a good story like in these games. It's more open world, which the more open world you get, the less story. Pretty much has been the case of everything. You're battling between, well, more choices or more story. When you increase one, you lose the other. I'm gonna hide behind this thing because I am not happy right now. There's rounds over there. There's gonna be some, they're gonna attack us up here. And I don't know where they're gonna come from now. Look at those rounds, they wanna draw us in there. It's a trap. That's a bird. Great holes over there. It's a trap!